Hi guys, it's Alice again. Welcome to my second vlog of my comp prep. Thanks to everyone who watched my first one and gave me some awesome feedback. I had so much positive feedback from that one, and I'm really glad that people are enjoying what I have to say and are interested in what I have to say. So this week's, I'm not going to blabber on too much, I will a little bit, but I've filmed a couple of things for you guys. This is Luna, this is my puppy. She's come to join in on the vlog this week. So, what's been happening? It's actually been quite a fast week. Not a lot has happened. But I had my check-in with my coaches on Saturday morning and everything's good. They haven't cut my calories or added any cardio yet, so still just chipping away. Losing body fat and measurements are going down while staying on that pretty constant calories, so that's all good. See ya. I did get quite sick over the weekend. This is my new fluffy robe that I bought for myself because I've had the flu since Saturday, so it's Wednesday today, so this is day 5 of just being rugged up and feeling pretty crappy. I tried to make myself look sort of presentable, but I don't think it's really worked. So when I had Ross River virus, I decided to drink turmeric every day, and I swear by the stuff, I think it is amazing. It has so many good anti-inflammatory properties, and I honestly swear that it is the reason I got better so quickly. So I've been making this smoothie for a couple of days, which actually tastes really good. So here it is. So here's my turmeric smoothie. Here's my all of my ingredients. I start off with almond milk. I like to put about half in. So the total recipe is 250 mils. So I'll add about 150 and then I add the rest at the end. Just helps with the blending. So next I'll add my egg whites. These are just pure egg whites that I get from Coles or Woolworths, and I add 45 grams of those just for a bit of extra protein. So next is chobani. I just use the plain zero fat chobani. Put it on the scales and I zero it. That way you know you're taking out exactly 50 grams and you can lick the spoon, because that is what you have accounted for. So 50 grams of that into the blender. So I freeze my bananas. I peel them and chop them up once they're really ripe. They've got those nice brown spots on them. I just put them in an airtight container in the freezer so that when I want to have smoothies, I can just add them and it makes them nice and cool and gives it a bit more texture. So just stirring those scales again. And I added 150 grams to this smoothie. If you had a few more carbs, you could have more, or if you had less carbs, you could just add less. Really is up to you how much you want to have. So next is peanut butter. I just go to my local health food store and they have a peanut grinder and it turns it into peanut paste, which is amazing. Tastes so good. So once again, just chucking it on the scales and zeroing it. Here comes Luna because she loves peanut paste and she knows the sound that the container makes when I open it, and she's always running to my side. So I did 20 grams of peanut butter. Once again, if you had more or less fats, you could add according to what your macros were. She wants the peanut butter so bad. vanilla protein I used for this, I just used my SciTech Nutrition, and I did 25 grams again, depending on how much protein you wanted.
more or less is fine. I think the vanilla really complements the turmeric and the other flavours that are already quite dominant in this recipe. So the star is the turmeric. So I did 2 teaspoons. I found that was enough. And then I added my cinnamon. So about 1 teaspoon of that. I love cinnamon. I add it to so many things. Add it to my oats, all my smoothies. And the last spice is cloves. So I did about 1/2 teaspoon. Of the ground cloves. It is quite a strong flavor, so don't add too much of it. And the most important is the pepper. So turmeric isn't well absorbed, and so if you are having turmeric in anything, make sure you add pepper. I added heaps because I love that spice that it gave to the smoothie. And then I just added the rest of the almond milk, so about 100 grams. Flavor is just amazing. It's quite a spicy smoothie due to those spices and the pepper, but oh, it is so good, and it really is an amazing spice.
It honestly sucks that I can't train, and it frustrates me a little bit to be 12 and a half weeks out and to be out for a couple of days, but I've been sticking to my diet 100% and just eating really healthy foods. And I think it is really important for me to just recover right now and get better so I don't prolong this flu. So I'm just resting today and taking it pretty easy. I think one of the things that people tend to lose while prepping for a competition is the nutrition. Obviously my background is, you know, nutrition and dietetics, and I think the last couple of weeks just trying to make it easier on myself and sort of being like, oh, I'm flexible dieting, so that means I can have this, I can have this. I've probably been a little bit too lenient and sort of lost that health side of things a little bit. And so this week I've really just tried to make an effort with eating heaps more veggies and more whole foods instead of ice cream and chocolate so much, which, you know, it's fine. Like, definitely keeps me sane knowing that I can have that and not feel guilty about it if I fit it into my macros, but my health is really important to me, so I really want to make that a priority while on this prep as well. So I'm currently on 1700 calories. I'm tracking my protein, carbs, fats and fiber. I didn't really want to tell people what my calories were because it's such a personal thing. Everybody's going to be so different. Obviously, I am in a deficit at the moment, and this is like probably the most calories that I've ever really been on. So it's really, really awesome for me to see my numbers going down, my photos looking better and better every week, even though I'm eating higher calories than I probably ever have. So yeah, it's really good. I've had, you know, obsessions with weight and everything before, and I'm not getting caught up in that. If my numbers don't change that much, it doesn't concern me too much. You know, I'm looking mostly at my photos and I'm seeing massive differences, so that's really awesome, and it's really good to see. So yeah, also I did film my back workout for you guys, but I did on Monday, so I was feeling pretty crappy, and I did probably go a little bit lighter, but surprisingly I felt really quite strong, so some of my sets were actually heavier than what I normally do, which was really cool. Me, myself, I got nothing to prove. You got a fast car, I got a plan to get us out of here. I've been working at a convenience store.
Man, she saves a little bit of money. Won't have to drive too far. Just cross the border and into the city. You and I can both get jobs. Finally see what it means to be living. You got a fast car. Fast enough so we can fly away. We gonna make a decision. Live tonight and die this way. So I remember we had tried.